Great. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can solve a bunch of probability and z-score problems using Excel function. So these questions are from Review Introductory Statistics Practice Problems. Okay, there are quite a few questions here, and just for time reason, I'm not going to go over every single one of them. I'm planning to do A, B, C, D, E, F, so they should go rather quickly. And then we're going to talk about and J and L as well. All of the answers are given at the very end of the practice problem, as you can see. Great. Just one reminder, we are dealing with a z-score or maybe a probability problem. Because we are dealing with a z-score and probability problems, there's a summary page in our slides. It's under empirical rule and normal distribution, slide 7. And slides 8, which summarize how you can use Excel function. Just a quick recap. If you know X, and we try to figure out the probability. We use Norm.Dist function in Excel, right? Usually it's much easier to figure out the left tail area compared to the right tail area. I mean, just one more step, one minus step. Okay, and if we do know, for example, area, that means a probability, if we have probability, and we try to figure out what the x is, well, it's going to be an inverse function that's known as norm.inv, right? Okay, if you're not sure, you can go back to the videos, and I have some demonstrations there too. Okay, so let's work on the practice problems. Okay, let's start with the first one. So what we have here is we have a bell curve, and we also know the center of the bell curve is mu, so that's a mean. The standard deviation is 1, and we know this quantity is -2.04. We try to figure out the shaded area. So this is a problem that we talked about. We know x, we have x. And we try to figure out what the probability is, right? So for this one, we just talked about that. We would use norm.dist function, as you can see, norm.dist function. Okay, so for A, it's going to be norm.dist. I'm going to write it out here. So it's a norm.dist. It takes 4 arguments. The very first one is the x value, which is -2.04. Mean, standard deviation, and the last argument is going to be true. So that means cumulative left tail. So this is how you can use Excel to figure out the shaded area. I think I'm going to go to part C first and then part B. For part C, we have a somewhat similar situation here. We know z-score. Okay, so we know this quantity. Instead of the left area, we want to figure out the right area. So that's somewhat different. So for part A, we want to figure out left area, and right now we want to figure out the right tail area. Well, all you need to do is use the same function, and you subtract the left tail area from 1. Okay, so I'm going to show you how can I do. So first, we're going to write norm.dist. The first argument, 1.71, as you can see here. 1.71. And then mean standard deviation, true, right? Okay, but this only gives us left tail, which is not what we wanted. So we can subtract the left tail from 1, and that's the final answer, right? Right. Okay, so let's move on to part B. Part B is different from what we worked on. In part B, we have the shaded area. We know this part is 0.03, about 3%. We want to figure out what the z is, right? What z is. Okay, so I'm going to erase it here a little bit. Okay. We are facing a different problem. We have the probability, and we try to figure out what the z is. So we're going to use norm.in function, which takes 3 arguments. Okay. So the very first one, part B, is a left tail. Left tail is usually easier to deal with compared to right tail. So it's a norm.in function. The first argument is the area, which we know it is 0.033. 0.0344, mean 0, standard deviation 1. Fairly easy. The next one is instead of giving us the left area, we have a right area, right? Right area. Okay. So we have to convert the right area to the left area so we can use the same Excel function. Again, it's going to be norm.inv function. So we subtract the area we were given. And put down the mean and standard deviation respectively, right? Okay, good. So let's move on to the next one. Part E and F are slightly more challenging. Okay, so in E, what we have here is we have a shaded area in the center. We also know that Z is positive 1.7 and negative Z is negative 1.747. So we're gonna use the symmetry of this to figure out shaded area. To find the shaded area, what we can do is we can find those two corners here and subtract them from 1 because we do know that 3 pieces add up to 1. So we can find, we can use 1 minus the left corner and then subtract the right corner, right? It's a per drawing. Okay. You may also realize instead of finding the left tail and right tail respectively separately, we can just find one of them and then multiply by 2 because you are using the symmetry of them. So I want to find this left corner. Usually left tail easier to find than right tail, as you can probably see from our previous example, right? It's slightly easier. So you can see this is a right tail, more complicated. Again, this is a right tail, more complicated. Okay, so let's do that. What we're gonna do is we wanna find the left tail. So that's 1 minus. To find the left tail, we're gonna use the norm.dist function. Because again, this time we have the x we know here, we just don't know the probability. Okay, so the z here, you wanna make sure you're using the right e, negative 1.47. The mean is 0, standard deviation is 1, and you want to write down 2 again, make sure you multiply 2, right? So fairly, you know, after, it's a little bit more complicated than earlier on, but it's still doable. For part F, we do have the shaded area. We know the shaded area is 0.8, and we try to figure out what Z is. So there's a negative Z and positive Z. Again, they are symmetric. Well, you probably can see the pattern. If we know the center area is 0.8, we can figure out those two corners first. Those are going to be super helpful. Okay, so those two corners is going to add up to 20% because we subtract 80% from 100%, that's 20%. So each corner should be 10%, right? 10%. So that means here is 10% and here is 10% as well. Okay, so if we do have the probability, now we want to figure out a z-score. So you can probably know this is a norm.inv problem. And you have the choice of using either the left tail or use the right tail. We usually go with the left tail because the left tail is easier to find. We have a left tail, a probability of 10%. We try to figure out what a z is. So this is going to be a norm.inv function. So the first argument is the probability, which is 10%, which we just calculated here, right? And the mean is 0, standard deviation is 1, and that should give us the correct answer, right? Right. I'm gonna move on to the next page. So there are 3 problems I want to cover here. The first one is a problem. We have A, we have B, and you may notice that the mean and standard deviation are no longer 0 and 1, so they are not standard normal. It's a mean 1 and standard deviation 1. And we try to figure out the area in between them, so that's this part. Whenever we are dealing with area in between, what you can do is you can figure out this area first, and then subtract this area. that would give us the area we wanted. So let's try to figure out this area first. To figure out this area, we do know the z or the x, which is b, and it was given to us to be 2 on the question. Okay, and we have the x, we want to figure out probability. So that's a norm.dist function, problem I. So the bigger area minus somewhere in the center. Okay, so it's going to be norm.dist. The x is 2, the mean is 1, the standard deviation is 1. Make sure you put down the last argument as 2. And for this area, because A is 1 and the center is also 1, so we know that this area is actually nothing but 50%, right? So minus 0.50. So that's going to be the final answer for part I, right? Okay, so let's move on to part J. Part J, what we have here is we know A is 2. We don't know B, but we also know the shaded area of them. Well, this problem is slightly more complicated. So what we're going to do here first is, because we do know here, so we can figure out what the area to the left of A. Okay, once we do that, we're going to add this area with the shaded area. We also know that's about 10%. So that would give us this area. With that piece of information, we should be able to figure out what the B is. Right? Okay, so there are several steps. First is we are going to figure out what is the area to the left of A. That's going to be a norm.dist function. Okay, so A is 2 and the mean is 0. Standard deviation is also 2, right? Okay, and make sure you end with a true. Okay. When you do that, you're probably going to get 0.8413. Okay, so that means here is about 84%. And we want to add up those 10%. Okay, so 0.8413 plus 0.1005. Okay, I'm going to add them up. You probably want to round at least 4 decimals. Okay, so 94% is this area. We know that to the left of B is about 94%. We should be able to figure out B using norm.inv function. So then the last step is going to be norm.inv function. 0.9418. That's what we just calculated here. The mean is 0.2, right? In Excel, you should get about 3.14. So that means B is 3.14. B is 3.14. Okay, so I'm going to move on to part L. So I need a little bit of space here. We know the mean is negative 3, standard deviation is 2, and we want to figure out the area in the middle. So usually when we find out area in the middle, we always use their difference of two curves. So first, the shaded area is the difference between this one and this one, right? So we're going to figure out the area of this one first, and then subtract the area of this one. To figure out the area, we use norm.dist. So I'm going to start with the this one. The bigger area is norm.dist, negative 1.02, mean is negative 3, standard deviation is 2, and make sure you have 2. So this gives us the bigger area. Now I'm going to move on to the smaller area. Again, it's going to be norm.dist, as negative 5.48, negative 3, 2, and 2. And final answer is going to be the difference between those two. The difference between these two. Right? Right. Okay. I covered some of more difficult problems in this practice question. Hopefully that's going to help you. Great. Thank you very much for watching.